Whoa, what's good, Hip Hop Society, and welcome back to another video. Today, we are bringing you a song from the Marshall Mathers LP. This has been requested for me to react to. It's similar to that poster, but that's the LP2. As you can see on my shirt, Marshall Mathers LP2. But this is from the original song, original album, excuse me, called Criminal. We're very familiar with this song. I have been requested to react to it by Nick F. Thank you, Nick. And I appreciate the support. There are other requests that I will get to. But in light of this Eminem series, I thought, why not react to an Eminem song? We are doing the homophobic misogynist series at the moment, where Eminem just rattles on his homophobic stuff. And we are enjoying this series, but now we're about to get into a song called Criminal. And how Eminem is not a criminal after this song. Well, he is a criminal. He's got some records. But how he wasn't locked up for like 80 years after this song, I don't know. Well, I do know the world's gotten a lot more sensitive than it was back then. But let's listen to this because it's a banger. Stupid fucking questions. A lot of people think that. That I actually do in real life, or that I believe in it, or that if I say that I'm gonna kill someone, that I'm actually gonna do it, or that I believe in it.
A lot of people ask me stupid fucking questions. A lot of people think that
what I say on record, or what I talk about on record, that I actually do in real life. Or that I believe in it, or if I say that I'm gonna kill someone,
kill somebody, I'm actually gonna do it, or that I believe in it.
Well, shit. If you believe that, then I'm gonna kill you.
I'll kill you.
Know why?
You know why? 'Cause I'm a criminal. With a jagged edge, it'll stab you in the head, whether you're a fag or less. Is it a homo sex, a math, or a trans or vest? Pants or dress, hate fags, the answer's yes. Homophobic, nah, you just heterophobic. Staring in my jeans, watching my genitals bulging. That's my motherfucking balls, you better let go of them. They belong in my scrotum, you'll never get hold of them. Hey, it's me, Versace, whoops, somebody shot me. And I was just checking the mail, get it, checking the mail.
This guy's so good at rapping. He can be so offensive, but still be so creative in his pen game. Like, hey, it's me, Versace, whoops, somebody shot me. And I was just checking the mail. Get it? Checking the mail. Because Versace was a gay man, and gay men's check mans out. But he was checking the mail like he was on his porch, because he was outside of his house checking his mail when he got shot. But he was... Eminem just being a homophobic kind of, really. He's just being...
You better let go of them. They belong in my scrotum. You'll never get hold of them. Hey, it's me, Versace. Whoops, somebody shot me. And I was just checking the mail.
Get it? Checking the mail. How many records do you expect me to sell after your second LP sends me the record to jail?
Come on.
Relax, guy. I like man. Right, Ken? Give me man. Hey, man.
Please, Lord, just born these Jesus. Heal the child, help us destroy these demons. Please send me a brand new car with a prostitute while my wife's sick in the hospital.
Like that. It's very comedic, but also it's got some sense of... That's the thing. Eminem's like, he said shit that's like controversial to say. But the only reason it's controversial to say is because it holds somewhat of a truth to it. Like, here he's talking from the perspective of a priest and saying, please, Lord, this boy needs Jesus. This boy being Eminem. Heal this child. Help him destroy these demons. Let's not get into the rhyme schemes because I can go on a tangent. Oh, and please send me a brand new car and a prostitute while my wife's sick in the hospital. So these preachers claim they be talking to God, healing all these children, preaching their sermons, Meanwhile, they take some of the money that the community gives the church and they spend it on prostitutes, new cars. While the priest's wife's sick in the hospital, he's out banging a prosy in his brand new Bentley. Like, it doesn't really make sense. It's a farce, if you will, for lack of a better word. So he makes it comedic, and we all like laugh at the joke and stuff, and like it's really like sick pen game and stuff. But like, if you deep it a bit, it's deep.
Send me a brand new car and a prostitute while my wife's sick in the hospital. Preacher, fifth grade teacher. You can't teach me, my mom can't either. You can't teach me a goddamn thing, cause I watch TV and Comcast.
See, yeah, he's saying exactly what I said. Preacher, and my fifth grade teacher. You can't reach me and my mom can't neither. You can't teach me a goddamn thing, cause I watch TV and Comcast cable. He's saying, whatever you try and do, you're never going to reach me. I'm too far gone. I watch TV. I don't know what Comcast is. I'm not American. But, like, probably, like porn or some shit, you know? Or, like, I don't know. So he's saying, like, he's too far gone. He's a criminal, bro. He's a criminal. See?
You can't stop me from dropping these charts. You can't stop me from dropping these smarts for a brand new CD for these fucking retards.
It's just a little on me.
Mr. Don't give a fuck, still won't leave. Cause every time I write a rhyme, these people think it's a crime to tell them what's on my mind.
And this is what I was thinking last night, because I saw TikTok of one of M's verses. And sorry to be stopping it in between the song, but I've heard the song, so I feel like I'm not reacting to the song, more like a breakdown of the song. So Eminem does this fantastic thing of coming up with a concept and stretching that concept to the absolute most. But what he does is, when he stretches that, you'll find that he can get so descriptive that he just paints a picture. So, for example, what song was I listening? Oh, I was listening to the Tim Westwood freestyle he did in 2010 yesterday. It was a TikTok clip that came up. And it was all about how crazy he is. So the first bar was like, my mind's deranged, I'm crazy or some shit like that. I can't really remember what the line was, but I watched it yesterday, lol. But he then went on to describe things that he would do. And the things that he was describing were just bizarre and like demonic and deranged. And a lot of people will be like, oh, but look at what he's rapping about. Fucking like Joe Biden in the Oval Office and doing this, and then he's jumping off the Eiffel Tower with the spark up his ass, and you know, it's like, it's not substantive, but what it is it's describing a concept. So like, for example, here in Criminal, the song's called Criminal, so the hook be, I guess I'm a criminal, but I don't gotta say a word, I just flip in the bird and keep going, I don't text from no one. He's saying, every time, in the previous hook, every time I write a rhyme, these people think it's a crime. So because he's got so much backlash from his music and what he includes in his lyrics, he's like, okay, well, I'm a criminal for rapping anyway, so let's fucking rap, bro. I'm a criminal. So he has a real good knack for stretching the truth so far that, and being so descriptive. Sorry about that, rant.
Cigarettes are speed. The baby came out disfigured ligaments and knee. It was a seed who would grow up just as crazy as she. Don't dare make fun of that baby, cause that baby was me. I'm a criminal, an animal case to turn crazed. But how the fuck you supposed to grow up when you weren't raised?
That bar is deep, cause his mother wasn't really very attentive. He's now cool with his mom, but as a kid, his mother wasn't very attentive to him. She was actually the opposite. She was kind of abusive in a way, but she had her own mental problems. But that's not the point. So you're saying, how the hell are you supposed to grow up when you weren't raised? And we all know that humans have a massive dependency, 18-year dependency as infants, youngsters, before you become an animal. Adult. My dick shrunk smaller and my balls got larger. I drank more liquor to fuck you up quicker than you wanna fuck me if I say the word. So, this bar. So as I got older and I got a lot taller, my dick shrunk smaller, but my balls got larger, so he got braver. His balls grew, he got braver, but he's saying his dick shrunk. It's just a little contrast. My pippy goes small, but my balls go big. He got a lot braver. I drank more liquor, so he was drinking a lot of alcohol and getting a lot of farts. And then you want to fuck me up for saying the word, and he leaves it out. That's because he said the N-word on a song called Oh Foolish Pride, where he made a diss track to an old high school girlfriend. She was a black girl, and she likes to stitch him up. He was cross, so he made a diss track, and he used the word. Quicker than you'd want to fuck me up for saying the word. My morals went when the president got moral sex in his Oval Office on top of his desk, off of his own employee. Now don't ignore me, you won't avoid me, you can't miss me. I'm white, blonde hair, and my nose is pointy. I'm the bad guy who makes fun of people that die in plane crashes and laughs as long as it ain't So if you're a long Eminem fan, I'm really sorry for pausing, but I'm the bad guy who makes fun of people that die. And hey, here's a secret to my Mathers LP, just to try to help people to buy. That's from Bad Guy in the Marshall Mathers LP 2. Think about how good this guy is and his reference lines. That's from this song, that line that he included. So he says his morals went out the window when the president got hit from Monica Lewinsky in the Oval Office. Like, this is a guy who's meant to be the president of a country, the moral standing for all Americans, busy getting copies in his office because Monica Lewinsky is hot. So how can you expect an artist to be professional and a role model when the president is in it? Slim Shady, almost crazy as Eminem combined. The maniac fan. Place to the doctor, cause Drake couldn't make it today. He's a little under the weather, so I'm taking his place. Oh, that's Drake. But an AK to his face. Don't make me kill him too. Spray's blaze all over the place. I told you, Drake, you should have kept that thing put away. I guess that'll teach you not to let me play with it. I'm a criminal! Alright, look. Scoping that motherfucker. Get that motherfucker, man. Alright. I'll be right here waiting on you. Alright. Yo, M. What? Don't kill nobody this time. He's a criminal. Of course he's gonna kill someone. Hi, how can I help you?
Hi. How you doing?
How can I help you?
Yeah, I need to make a withdrawal.
Check the money in the bag. Come on in the bag. I'm not gonna fucking kill you. Thank you.
Thank you. Windows tinted on my ride when I drive in it.
When a rubber bank right up to dive in it, so I'll be disguised in it.
And if anybody identifies the guy in it, I hide for 5 minutes. Come back, shoot the eyewitness. Fire at the private eye, hide the pride in my business.
Hold on, I nearly broke my keyboard, but how good is that? Bro, now we're gonna talk about pen game and rhyme scheme. Now we're gonna talk about that shit. Now we're gonna talk about pen game and rhyme scheme. So he's just robbed a bank. And this is just where I'd like flowing cadence and multi-rhyming syllables just takes my breath away. Windows tinted on my ride when I drive in it. So when I rob a bank, run out and just hide in it. So I'll be disguised in it. Look at the in it. And you think you can't rhyme in it with in it, but the why you can rhyme in it with in it is because if you go one word back, drive, dive, and disguised are all different words that rhyme, and it just connects the syllables so well when you're doing something like that. So you can take the same word and rhyme it, as long as the preceding words have some sort of rhyme as well. Because if you say, I jumped in it, I drove in it, and I fucked in it. It's like no, because there's no rhyming. You're just using in it. But he drove, he dived, and he disguised. It's fantastic, and it's not even finished.
When I rob a bank, run out and just dive in it, so I'll be disguised in it. And if anybody identifies the guy,
See, he's back with it. And if anybody identifies that the syllables are still rhyming, disguised identifies. I'll hide for five. So now there's more syllables being included. Hide for 5 minutes. And minutes rhymes with in it. So he's got in it, minutes. Drive, dive, disguise, identifies, I'll hide for 5. Bro, you don't know what this guy... And then he comes back with shoot the eyewitness. So eyewitness rhymes with in it, minute. The eyewitness rhymes with hard 5, identifies, disguise, dive, and drop. Bro, this guy is just an alien, man. He's an alien. So I'll be disguised in it. And if anybody identifies the guy in it, I hide for 5 minutes. Come back, shoot the eyewitness. Fire at the private eye, hide to pry in my business. It's not even finished. Fire at the private eye, hide to pry in my business. And the story that he's telling, like, he's describing what's going to happen if somebody identifies me as the murderer. Bro, and he's, like I said, he stretches the concept. And it's just brilliant. I wish I could go on for hours. I have 16 minutes. Bro. Bruh. Bruh. I'm just scratching my pubicles. Bruh. That song. You see, there's a... Bruh, that's that song. Even the end there, he says... I don't take... Yeah. Last little... breakdown. So he says, half the shit I say, I just... If it's not a risk that I say, I just make it up. To make you mad, kiss my white naked ass. And if it's not a rap, I say, chickens ain't brave enough to say this. Talk my... He says, if I ever gave a fuck, I would shave my nuts, tuck my dick in between my legs, and cluck. You motherfucking chickens ain't brave enough. So clucking chickens, chickens cluck. He says, if you ever catch me give a fuck, I'm going trance. That's not what he's saying, but he'll tuck his dick in his legs and cluck, make himself look like a dude. So he says, to say the stuff I say, so just... Half the shit I say, I just make it up. So nothing he says is like he doesn't mean any of it. He just says it to make you mad. Because you guys get mad at the shit he says. So he says, kiss my white naked ass. And if it's not a rapper... And if it's not a rapper that I make it as, I'ma be a fucking rapist in a Jason mask. Jesus Christ, Eminem. But how have you managed to survive in the industry? You can't cancel him. Bro, Machine Gun Kelly did a diss track to this man. 5 years later, he's now a woman. MGK. Like, man is goated, bro. Goated. Nick, you're a fucking G, man. Thank you. I would never have reacted to this song because I've listened to the song like 1,000 times. And breaking that song down was actually really fun. So, if you guys really enjoyed that track with me, I would love you to subscribe. I would love you to like, I would love you to comment, and I would love you to ring that bell. We're trying to make some bread off of this game. We're trying to, if see, if I can live off of this type of shit, then I'm doing what I really, really love. I'm making money off what I love. I can bring some new content to you guys. So like, join the movement. It's not about the money, but we need money to do what we want to do. So you know what I'm saying? I'm not asking you for money. Actually, don't subscribe. Keep, actually, no, never, well, I'm a, support the movement. We're going to bring you some awesome content and peace out and our way because like you're such nice people. Thank you for watching, guys. Peace out on our way.